Hello students, this class is for class 12 and we were discussing chemical kinetics. So in the first class we have studied how to find the order of a reaction and what is elementary and complex reactions. In today's class we will start from the rate law of a zero order reaction. Okay, so at first we are writing a zero order reaction. Suppose the general reaction is A to P, or this is the reactant and giving product. So if we say that this is a zero order reaction, so how can we write the rate? So for rate you can write, you know, K is the rate constant, concentration of A, and the order of the reaction goes to the power of the reactant concentrations. You know that the order of any reaction, if we say that this is zero order reaction, so the order will be zero and it will go to the power of the reactant. So K, concentration of A to the power zero. Now according to mathematics, anything to the power zero, suppose 2 to the power zero, 3 to the power zero, x to the power zero, anything, whatever you take to the power zero means it's equal to 1 always. This is according to mathematics. So we can write that if we are writing it is a zero order reaction and zero goes to the power of the reactant concentration, then it becomes equal to K, that is the rate constant. Okay, so rate equal to rate constant. So you can say that zero order reaction is independent of the reactant concentration. See, reactant concentration to the power 0 means it becomes equal to 1. That's why it is independent of reactant concentration. Okay. So we can say zero order reaction is independent of reactant concentration. Zero order reaction is independent of reactant concentration to the power 0 equal to 1. Now how rate law can be derived? There are two methods to write down this rate. You can write as according to product, that is d concentration of P by dt. Whenever you are trying to write with respect to product, there will be positive sign. And when you are trying to write with respect to reactant, it will be minus T concentration of A by dt. I have explained in your offline class that this process is, that is how to write the rate with respect to product and with respect to reactant. So dp dt or minus da dt equal to, these two are the rates, it's equal to K into 1 means K, like this. Okay. So we are taking this reactant, so minus d concentration of A by dt equal to K. Okay, reactant concentration decreases with time, that's why this minus sign is given here. That means the reactant concentration is decreasing with the progress of the reaction. So we are taking this minus da dt equal to K as we have got. So minus da equal to K into dt, this one. Now we will apply integration. Apply integration, integration of da, integration of K is constant. The constant will remain outside the integration. K is a constant, so it remains outside of that of integration sign. And this is C, the integration constant. Integration constant. So minus da equal to minus a, you will get here k into t. Integration of dt means t, integration of da means a plus c. Okay. Now in the reaction is what? A to p. You will apply two times at t equal to 0. At t equal to 0. That means when the reaction is just started, t equal to 0. 0 minute, 0 second, whatever you say, at t equal to 0, this reactant concentration is A0, this is the initial state. And when the reaction has just started, no product has been produced, so product concentration is 0. And at t equal to t, after some time. After some time, suppose it is 10 minute, after 10 minute, that is T, the reactant concentration becomes A, and some amount of product has been produced, and suppose the product has been produced is X. I see. So now this apply to T conditions in this equation. Apply T equal to 0, at T equal to 0. This is the T we have got. At T equal to T, concentration of reactant is A. See, when this is T, concentration of reactant is A, that is okay. But what about when T equal to 0, apply T equal to 0. At T equal to 0, what happens? At T equal to 0, concentration of A means A0. So right here A0, concentration of A becomes A0 initial, apply T equal to 0 here, T equal to 0 applying plus C. Next, it becomes minus A0 equal to C. Okay, we have got minus A0 equal to C. So this is the value of C. Now put this value of C in this equation. In this equation. So we are writing that from this equation we are getting minus A equal to KT plus the value of C after putting T equals to T is equal to 0, we have got the value of C is minus A0. So put here minus A0. In place of C, we are putting this minus A0. Now we have got A0 minus A equal to KT. This is the integrated rate law for zero order reaction. This is called the integrated rate law for a zero order reaction. And from here we can explain the graphical representation of any rate law. The graphical representation of any rate law, that is, any rate law means for any zero order reaction. So if we draw the concentration of A versus time, concentration of A versus time, if we plot, then here from concentration of A we are getting A0 minus KT. See, from here we are getting concentration of A means A0 minus KT. So concentration of A versus T, when we plot, T means this one is negative slope, minus K. Minus K means slope will be negative. So negative slope, this slope is minus K. And what about the intercept? This one, this A0 is the intercept. And this graph has been plotted according to Y equal to MX plus C. This is the straight line equation. Y equal to MX plus C is the straight line equation where M is the slope. Y versus X plot. This M is the slope. Here positive slope means M is positive. But here I have drawn downwards because it is negative. See, this T is like, this is MX plus C and this is Y. So this M, the slope is negative, so that's why negative. T is just like X, see X. And this A is like Y. Y is A like this. Okay. So just like Y equal to MX plus C, we have got the integrated rate law equation and corresponding graph. Okay. So if we draw the graph of rate versus reactant concentration, this one. This is the A versus T, that is reactant concentration versus T. But if instead of reactant concentration, this is reactant concentration. If instead of reaction concentration, if we plot rate versus T, this will be straight line. Why? Because remember the first step, rate equal to K into concentration of A to the power 0, and it becomes K into 1. So for zero order reaction, this rate does not depend on the reactant concentration. From the first step, I have said that for a zero order reaction, rate does not depend on the reactant concentration because the power is zero here. So as it does not, it will be concentration of A. Okay, So rate versus reactant concentration, this one. So you can see that rate does not depend on the reactant concentration, and that's why rate versus reactant concentration graph becomes straight line here. Okay, two types of graph. So in the next class we will start from the half life of zero order reaction. Okay.